creating gardens in your balconies and start growing your own garden. So the vertically you start refixing your carbon dioxide in your own areas. That's the only thing that you can do by simply refixing carbon dioxide. How can you do this? How can you refix your carbon dioxide? By planting more trees, by putting more seedlings, including your convert all your concrete areas into green areas, grow more and more plants. So you can do this around your home, terraces, balconies, interiors, courtyards. But we all know the biggest contributor to global warming is petrochemicals, not only petrochemicals, man also. Man has equally contributed to all these disasters that are happening now by not being friendly with nature. Okay, we all know that, you know, Mother Earth was a very beautiful, you know, it was a very godly place billions of years back. Now after cleanup, we have a lot of these things which got solidified and went down into Earth's crust as what we know as petrochemicals. Okay, petroleum, oil. Now what man has done, what Earth took around millions of years for cleaning it up and making it a beautiful place, man has simply extracted it, mined it and taken it out in 50 years time. That's what man has actually done and spoiled the whole place. Now you can just see pictures of places where the disintegrating ice shelf, which was lost 1200 square miles of section, and how the land-based glaciers which are added to the sea levels. If you look at these pictures, the really pathetic situations what's happening in the world today. Take a look at the picture there. The area in Alaska regions where we had lot of areas of Earth's level converted slowly into these areas. Around the globe we normally have sea level about 6 inches higher than it was already 100 years ago. And look at where this little polar bear is moving around. He's supposed to be going around in ice, right? He's walking around where there's no ice at all there for him to move around. So you can see the pictures of these disappearing glaciers. What were once beautiful glaciers, there's no glaciers, completely disappeared. You can have picture, we have pictures here from Austria. Okay, you can keep on, if you look into a Google search, you can see all these disappearing glaciers and pictures of how man has contributed to make these scenes endless. So what we need to actually do is now be responsible, contribute in a much healthier way to grow your own food from your own garden. How can you do that? Start composting. Why were you? You are only responsible for your actions. So refix your carbon dioxide, I already told you this, into your own homes, interiors, by doing vertical gardening. And the simple concept of refusing, reducing, reusing and recycling, the 4 R's in recycling. Okay. So refusing, reducing, reusing and recycling commodities which can lead to waste. Please start doing this from NOW. Okay, here are some statistics which I don't want to bore you on this, but I can just give you a few minutes to look into this. Now if you have a small city with some 10 lakh houses which can generate around 300 kgs per house, we can end up with around 3 lakh metric tons of organic planting media, which is equivalent to around 4000 metric tons of urea, 800 metric tons of potash and 800 metric tons of rock phosphate. They're all chemical fertilizers, which can provide around 1 lakh metric tons of per year of organic vegetables, fruits and flowers. Now the cost of centralized composting. Now why I'm talking to you about a centralized area is, what we're doing now is, each one of you are collecting waste. All of this waste is being transported again to another facility, right? Then again you are utilizing petrochemical, again you are using petrol and for moving, transporting this waste again to another place. So what you need to do is, you segregate and compost at source. So wherever you do your segregation, compost it right there. So you don't have to use fuel again, use your car or vehicle to transport the waste to another place and do a composting there. Okay, you are all with me? Why I am talking to you about composting at source. The cost per year for 10 lakh houses will be almost around 35 crores per year, which can go up to around 7,500 metric tons of carbon dioxide per year. You know, that's something that needs to be thought about. The first thing, think. You know, you just can't digest this particular you know, the idea that you are actually wasting around 7,500 metric tons of carbon dioxide per, yes, I'm leaving you with this for advantage of society in terms of carbon footprints. So I told you earlier, please start, stop using commercial toxic vegetables, grow organic food in your own house, teach these little children about the value of cultivation and legacy of ancestors, enhance even your physical and mental health, you can save energy and create your own food security. Thank you so much. I think I would like to actually thank Mr. Shona for giving me the opportunity to talk here. I wish, you know, if I wish I could have made my presentation much more, you know, suited to your children's program. But I think you all got enlightened a little bit at least on how to do waste management in your home. I would like to have a small demonstration about what we're doing in apartments and even here at Brunton Boat here and other corporates. Okay, so we can we go there and just take a look at the composting.
Bio bin. This is a FRP fiber reinforced plastic bin which has been used in apartments for composting the kitchen waste. Now, as I told you, this bin is what is being used at present at Mr. Menon's place apartment. This can cater to around 20 to 30 houses. In 1 month, it will completely get filled up. You can leave it covered, you will end up in a potting media. If you look at this bin, it has been designed to suit the aerobic composting for the fungi to keep growing. So here we have a mesh at the bottom where you have a... So we have an aerobic condition created here. Now we have these four aerating pipes. So
we first put the... Okay. Okay guys, first we put...
First we put this compost off.
Fill for the whole area.
Make sure that you don't have any space in the sides so that the organic matter will go into the sides. It will prevent the composting. Always make sure that your whatever exposed to air is your pelletage composter. So now what Ms. Men is doing is completely filling up around 2 inches layer of the pelletage composter and creating a spongy layer for composting.
You need to fill whole the area.
It's almost done.
Okay. Now, I'm going to put kitchen waste.
This is like 20 kilos. What is the weight of this?
20 kilos.
Okay. So we can put one layer and put 20 kilos. This is normally a standardized quantity that we talk about. If you had left it aside, this waste would have been stinking, right? Now the moment you start putting compost up, the smell will start disappearing because the property of this is to absorb the stench.
Fill it the same way. And you can go up to 5 inches.
Waste. You can even put eggshells also, no problem. Eggshell contains the albumin, the protein part, which can also go into the nutrition part of the media. You can put orange peels, you can put non-vegetarian waste.
I think they need to...
Yeah, okay, now, first we put a composter and now we fill with the kitchen waste. Yeah? There is no plastic, there is no capsule, there is nothing is there. It's only food waste.
The gravy they need to...
Yes. You have to remove the liquid portion of, supposing you have sambar, please take away the liquid portion which can go into your sink. Take only the solid material and put it into the bin, okay? We try to avoid some liquid materials.
Okay, now, you can get a little bit smell, right? As soon as we put this one, smell will go off.
So here again, you are going to make sure that your topmost layer is going to be your pelletage composter, the spongy material which will allow aeration. And once you put this and keep layers, just like how at home we don't disturb the curd when it is happening, right? Will you go and see, put your spoon and see whether the curd is happening? No, you don't do that. Similarly here also, you have a fungi which is growing. Please don't keep disturbing it from here. Put a big stick and do some row about and see whether it is growing or not. Please don't disturb the Everything have a small part. Don't disturb your fungus which is growing. Just see whether you can make it from the second layer whether it's actually getting composted or not. Okay, please be patient. It is going to take around 30 to 45 days for completing your composting. Don't be in a hurry to see whether it will happen in, if you put more compost or whether it will not work out that way. Okay, they are all live organisms. Let's allow them to have their own life cycle and work in their own way.
So now the smell is spoiled. See, this is the way. I just give you a little bit of idea. வளர தான் தாமஸ்கின் சொல்லுது 41 அப்பார்ட்மெண்ட்ஸ் இது நோமலி சிட்டிலான தாமசிக்கிறது ஒரு இண்டஸ்ட்ரி ஜோஸ் ஜென்ஷன் எவ்ரிபடி நோ த ஜோஸ் ஜென்ஷன் ஸோ அப்படி ஐ வாஸ் இன் யுனைடெட் ஸ்டேட் ஃபார் கப்பிள் ஆஃப் இயர்ஸ் 15 இயர்ஸ் கழிஞ்சிட்டு ஞான் வந்து வந்தப்போ ஞான் எங்க ஃபஸ்ட்டில் ஒரு இம்ப்ரெஷன் காண பற்றியது வீட்டில் ஓரோ சைடிண்ட் ஃபிளாட்டின் கோணர்லும் ஓரோ பின் வச்சிட்டு அதில் கிச்சன் வேஸ்ட் எடுத்து കുപ്പി ആയിട്ട് വേസ്റ്റ് എടുത്തു പ്ലാസ്റ്റിക് വേസ്റ്റ് എടുത്തു എല്ലാം കൂടി മിക്സ് ആക്കി അവിടെ വെക്കും പിന്നെ ഞാൻ താമസിക്കുന്ന സ്ഥലത്ത് ഹോട്ടൽസൊക്കെ ഒരുപാട് ഉണ്ട് അപ്പോൾ അടി കൂടി എലികൾ ഒരു വൈകുന്നേരം ഒരു 6-7 മണിയായ എലികളെല്ലാം വന്ന് അതിനെ എടുത്ത് തിന്നെ അവർക്ക് പ്രശ്നമുണ്ട് അതിനെ എടുത്ത് തിന്നെ അവിടെ എല്ലാം റെഡാക്കി കണ്ടീനേഴ്സ് എല്ലാം കടിച്ച് റെഡിയാക്കി ടോട്ടലി മെസ് ഇറ്റ് ഇസ് സ്മെല്ലിങ് സോ ഐ തോട്ട് യു നോ വി നീഡ് ടു ഡു സംതിങ് ഞാൻ അസോസിയേഷനിൽ വിളിച്ച് എല്ലാവരെയും വിളിച്ച് പറഞ്ഞ് എന്തെങ്കിലും ചെയ്യണം ബട്ട് യു നോ ടുഡേ Nobody, no community, nobody is interesting. Everybody is busy. Everybody is busy and everybody is running around with our own work. So I thought, okay, we need to take initiative. When I come to meet, he has husband, Dr. Manoj. So Manoj is given an idea, that's why I didn't do this. This is 1.5 years. Almost one and a half years. Now we tried and I go on each and every house, we train them and we given a different basket, we have to put a plastic waste, we have to put a kitchen waste, we have to put a other one, napkin or whatever it is. So we given one or two seminar and classes to keep knowledge each and every housewife, each and every people. So it was quite okay, 40% people are understand. And again they mixing each and everything with a basket to basket. So what I had taken the idea, I go each and every house, taken the students like you guys. I teach them. You are the people who are going to teach your parents. அவரெல்லாரும் வந்து அவரெல்லாரும் என்ன சப்போர்ட் செய்து அவர் வளர டீசென்ட் ஆயிட்டுள்ள ஹோம்வொர்க் ஆட்சி ரெண்டு தூசம் செய்து അവർക്കെല്ലാം പറഞ്ഞ് മനസ്സിലാക്കി കൊടുക്കും ഈ സ്റ്റുഡൻസ് പോയിട്ട് എല്ലാവരുടെ വീട്ടിലും പോയിട്ട് അവർ നമ്മുടെ അപ്പാർട്ട്മെൻറ്റിൽ താമസിക്കുന്ന സ്റ്റുഡൻസ് തന്നെ വീട്ടിലെല്ലാവരോടും പറഞ്ഞ് മനസ്സിലാക്കി കൊടുക്കും അതിനുശേഷം ഇവരുപടി ഫസ്റ്റ് ഇത് ഞങ്ങളുടെ ഈ 41 അപ്പാർട്ട്മെൻറ്റ്സ് കൊണ്ട് ഇങ്ങനത്തെ ഒരു കണ്ടെയ്നർസ് ഞങ്ങൾക്ക് 18 days ഞങ്ങളുടെ കണ്ടെയ്നർസ് ബിക്കോസ് ഞാൻ അവിടെ ഒരു ശ്ലോകം കണ്ടു നമ്മൾ ഈ ഇപ്പോഴും നമ്മൾ ഹോട്ടൽസിലൊക്കെ പോയാൽ നമ്മൾ ബൊഫെ കാര്യങ്ങൾ എടുക്കും ഫസ്റ്റ് നമ്മൾ വേണ്ടാത്തതും വേണ്ടതും എല്ലായിടത്തും പ്ലേറ്റിലുണ്ട് അൾട്ടിമേറ്റ്ലി എന്താ ചെയ്യാൻ പോണ് ഒരു 50% കാർഡിലും ഫുഡ് നമ്മൾ 60% ഫുഡ് ഞങ്ങളവിടെ ആ ഫ്ലൈറ്റിൽ തന്നെ അവിടെ വയ്ക്കും അല്ലെങ്കിൽ അവിടെ ബാസ്കറ്റിൽ വയ്ക്കും ഇതേ കാര്യമാണ് വീട്ടിലും ചെയ്യാൻ പോകുന്നത് ചെയ്യുന്നത് ഒന്നാമത് ഇപ്പോഴത്തെ ഒരു സാഹചര്യത്തിൽ ഫുഡ് ഒരിക്കലും വേസ്റ്റ് ചെയ്യും പിന്നെ മറ്റേ എക്സിക്യൂട്ടീവ് ഷെഫ് അജിത് പറഞ്ഞു ലോക്കൽ ഫുഡ് ഞാൻ ആക്ച്വലി ഞാൻ മുറിച്ച് ഒറിജിനലി ഫ്രം പാലക്കാട് ഞാൻ വീട്ടിൽ ഉള്ള സമയത്ത് എനിക്കിപ്പോൾ ഒരു 50 വയസ്സായി ഓർ മേ ബി 35 years ബിഫോർ ഞാനെന്താ ഞങ്ങളുടെ വീട്ടിലെ കിച്ചൺ ഗാർഡനിൽ മാത്രമുള്ള വെജിറ്റബിൾ മാത്രമേ ഞങ്ങൾ ഉണ്ടാക്കുന്നു ലോക്കൽ ഫുഡ് ചീരാണിച്ച ചീര മുരിങ്ങാണിച്ച മുരിങ്ങ വെണ്ടാണിച്ച വെണ്ട ഒരു കറി ഒരു ഉപ്പേര് അങ്ങനെ വല്ലതും മാങ്ങയുണ്ടെച്ച അച്ചാറ് എന്തൊക്കെയുള്ള ഞങ്ങൾ എൻ്റെ ഓർമ്മയിൽ എനിക്ക് ഇല്ല ഞങ്ങൾ മാർക്കറ്റിൽ പോയിട്ട് വെജിറ്റബിൾ വാങ്ങിയത് എത്ര സുന്ദരമായിരുന്നല്ലോ എത്ര ടേസ്റ്റ് ഉണ്ടാവും അല്ലേ ഇപ്പം നമ്മൾ എന്തൊരു സാധനം വാങ്ങിയാലും അത് അതിൻ്റെ ഭംഗി കാണാം പക്ഷെ മുറിച്ച് കഴിക്കുന്ന സമയത്ത് ടേസ്റ്റ് ഒന്നുമില്ല അപ്പോൾ അങ്ങനത്തെ ഒരു സിറ്റുവേഷൻ നിങ്ങളായിട്ടുള്ള ഈ യങ്ങായിട്ടുള്ള ജനറേഷൻ ഇനീഷ്യേറ്റീവ് എടുത്താൽ മാത്രമേ നമുക്ക് ഈ നമ്മുടെ ലോകത്തിന് വളരെ ബ്യൂട്ടിഫുൾ ആക്കാൻ പറ്റുള്ളൂ ഗോഡ്സ് ഓൺ കൺട്രിയോട് നമ്മുടെ പ്രത്യേകിച്ച് ഒരു കേരളത്തിൽ ഞാൻ 74 countries വിസിറ്റ് ചെയ്തു തിരിച്ച് കേരളത്തിൽ വന്നു ഇത്രയും നല്ലൊരു ബ്യൂട്ടിഫുൾ ആയിട്ടുള്ളൊരു സ്റ്റേറ്റ് നമ്മുടെ ലോക്കലായിട്ട് ഇപ്പൊ നമ്മൾ ഫോർട്ട് കൊച്ചി കാണിച്ചാൽ ഫോർട്ട് കൊച്ചി നിങ്ങൾ ഓരോരുത്തരും കമ്മ്യൂണിറ്റി സർവീസ് തുടങ്ങാം. ചെറിയ ചെറുതായിട്ട് വേസ്റ്റ് മാനേജ്മെന്റ് പറ്റിയിട്ടും നല്ലൊരു കാര്യം നമ്മൾ ചെയ്തു വെക്കുക. ഇന്ന് തൊട്ട് എല്ലാവരും പ്രോമിസ് ചെയ്യുക, എന്തെങ്കിലും ഞാൻ അറ്റ്ലീസ്റ്റ് എൻ്റെ വീട്ടിലെങ്കിലും അമ്മയ്ക്ക് പറഞ്ഞ് മനസ്സിലാക്കി കൊടുക്കുന്നു, സിസ്റ്റർ പറഞ്ഞു കൊടുക്കുക, അല്ലെങ്കിൽ ഞാൻ തന്നെ ചെയ്യുന്നു, അങ്ങനത്തെ കാര്യങ്ങൾ നമ്മൾ ചെയ്യുക. ചെയ്ത് നമ്മുടെ ബ്യൂട്ടിഫുൾ ആയിട്ടുള്ള ഒരു സ്റ്റേറ്റിനെ അതിമനോഹരമാക്കി മാറ്റുക. ഗോഡ്സ് പോയ ഗോഡ്സിനെ തിരിച്ചു കൊടുക്കുക അല്ലേ. ഓക്കെ, താങ്ക് യു.
Yeah, please begin the session.
Sure. Open for discussion. Please raise your questions at this forum.
At one point in a day, you should collect the waste from all the 20 houses and then put it into the bin. And put it into the bin, that is a one day's contribution. Now, I am kind of talking to you about a 20 kg will be a normal, like Mr. Menon's apartment, you have 40 houses and half a kg, I am assuming 20 kg. That's why I asked him to take 20 kg waste today. A 20 kg would be an ideal thing where you get filled up within 20 days or something, you get completely filled up. So if you have 20 houses, you can use the bio bin for composting for 20 houses for one day. You can keep collecting every day. So when you have 20 kg, you can start putting all that into your bio bin. Have I cleared your question? Okay.
Can you tell us what is the cost of this bin?
This bin,
houses,
and
what about the individual houses, only this?
Individual houses, you need only small, you have only half a kg, right? You don't need such a big bin. We are talking about big bins only for huge apartment complexes, residential apartments. Or supposing you have a villa type houses, you have 20 houses, and they want, where they have these small pots,
so
where you can use
bio bin.
You don't have to use the bio bin, but in schools you can use the bio bin. Now, where you have large quantity of waste being generated in a single day, you can go in for the bio bin. So we have kind of done research and found out that around 20 houses would require one bio bin. So we have come to a situation where wherever there are 40 houses, we have installed two bins, because once the first bin gets filled up, you have to start composting with the waste. So we give them another bin, they can start filling up the second bin. By the time this bin gets filled up, the first one will be completely composted. So we always go in for a twin pair. We don't give a single bin, because when this gets filled up, automatically you need to start composting in the second bin. That's the reason why we are talking about a 7-pot package here. So by the time your 7th pot is filled up, your first pot is ready for using as a potting media. You can grow your own vegetables. Have you cleared your question?
Sorry?
One pot in one day. No, it will take some time. 7 to 8 days. It will take time.
It depends on how much waste you have.
You generate it. Polyphenols. Yes? Good. Nice to remember it. Next. I told you one more thing, right? Biodegradable and biocompostable. Please study all these things. It's very, very important to you. You will enjoy waste management. Once you know these concepts, you will actually enjoy doing it. Okay, anything else, please? Okay, so the nicest thing to that you can, the best way to learn is actually keep doing this. Start doing these things. Plant your own seedling. If you can get a chance, please visit Mr. Menon's apartment complex, where they have grown tomatoes, chilies, chira with their own kitchen waste. And they have converted a beautiful, they have converted the concrete building into beautiful garden. Vertical gardening, horizontal gardening. They have done beautiful landscaping in their own apartment complex. See, one thing is, apartments complexes don't have space. So here we are talking about a 1 square meter space for your composting. That is, one bin will take 1 square meter space. So you need 2 square meter space for 2 bins, and your composting can actually happen. Okay, so you don't have to worry about not having any space in your apartment complex. So that's one, you know, challenge that's happening in apartment complexes all over. Anything else, please?
We were discussing about cities, apartments, and where the people who lives rich. How can we implement these kind of things in the poor people or the local people or otherwise in the remote villages?
Remote villages, we can promote these garden kits in a subsidized rate. We are actually, I want to tell you this, we have been, this product has been registered with the Swachhata Mission, the Government of Kerala organization working on waste management. And through panchayats, we are a service provider for these compost up kits. And panchayats, we are able to sell this on subsidized rates to people in villages and various panchayats.
So you'll be doing any seminars, camps or something like that?
We'll be giving them demonstration. So we'll be going to so we have got orders from around 11 to 12 panchayats as of now. So we'll be going to the panchayats and give them a technical demonstration how to do this, and then they'll be selling these kits. So we're also the compost up, since it is registered with the recognized for the Swachhata Mission, the government of Kerala will give subsidies for people who take this up.
So we can get these things from the panchayat offices?
Not as of now, it's not yet come. Okay. It has reached the registration level. We have to come in the service provider list. It's taking some time. It's almost been now 2 years now. We are working on this, but I think the government is a little slow working on these paperwork and documentation. It's taking some time. But I would feel that, you know, let's not wait for all the government papers to go through and start. Let's start doing it right now. Let's start composting right away. Like what Mr. Varun is doing. He didn't wait for the government order or sanction letter to come. He just started doing it.
Thank you, ma'am. I think Mr. Varun wants to say something. എന്നിട്ട് അവരുള്ള അപ്രോച്ച് നമ്മളോട് ചെയ്യും. അല്ലാതെ ഒരു ആരെയും ബ്ലെയിം ചെയ്യണ്ട. വി ആർ റെസ്പോൺസിബിൾ ക്രിയേറ്റിംഗ് അവർ ഓൺ വേസ്റ്റ്. ഒരു ചായ കുടിച്ചിട്ട് നമ്മളൊരു ഗ്ലാസ്സോ കപ്പോ അല്ലെങ്കിൽ വല്ലതും വെച്ച് കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ കുറച്ച് നേരം കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ നമ്മൾ അതിനെ തന്നെ നോക്കും, അയ്യോ ഈ വേസ്റ്റ് നമ്മുടെ അവിടെ നിന്ന്. ഹു ക്രിയേറ്റഡ് ദാറ്റ്? ഔസർ, റൈറ്റ്? ആ ഒരു ഒന്ന് നമ്മുടെ ബ്രെയിനിലേക്ക് ഒന്ന് പോയി കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ നമുക്ക് എല്ലാം മാനേജ് ചെയ്യാനേ ഉള്ളൂ. ഇപ്പൊ ഞാനിവിടെ വന്നു, നിങ്ങൾ വിചാരിക്കണ്ടാവും അയ്യോ ഈ ആൾ കച്ചറ കയ്യിൽ കൊണ്ട് എടുത്തിട്ട് ഇങ്ങനെ ചെയ്യുന്നു. കുറച്ച് പ്രാക്ടീസ് ആയി കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ ചെയ്യും, നിങ്ങൾ എല്ലാവരും ഒന്നായി ചെയ്യും. അപ്പോ ഈ നമ്മളാണ് വയസ്സ് ക്രിയേറ്റ് ചെയ്യുക എന്നുള്ള ഒരു ബോധം നമുക്ക് വന്നു കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ അതിനെ നമ്മൾ നെക്സ്റ്റ് സ്റ്റെപ്പ് ആയിട്ട് നമ്മൾ തിങ്ക് ചെയ്യാനുള്ള ഒരു കടമ നമുക്കുണ്ട്. ആരും നമ്മൾ ബ്ലെയിം ചെയ്യേണ്ട ആവശ്യമില്ല. താങ്ക് യു.
Thanks a lot. Thank you very much.
With this, we have come to an end of today's program. I would be failing in my responsibility if I do not thank all who have made this program a big success. First and foremost, I would like to thank the speakers of the day, Chef Ajit and Dr. Priya, for this wonderful and insightful session that they've given us. I do take this opportunity to thank Pelican Biotech and Chemicals Private Limited and Ms. Sheba Rajan, headmistress of Delta School, for their extended cooperation and support. Sheila Rajan. A special thanks to our general manager, Mr. Radhakrishna Sharanai, who was fully involved in this wonderful initiative, and all associates of Brandon Boatyard for bringing their program together today. And of course, a big thank you to the parents and students of Delta School who have come here today on our special invitation. Thank you all. You all have enjoyed and learned something new today, right? Now do join us for refreshment that have been arranged. Thank you once again and have a good day. Wish you all a very happy Environment Day.
Valuable time with us. I know, sir, you are a champion of the environment as far as I am concerned.
It's my pleasure to deliver the word of thanks. We had a wonderful time today having a look at this heritage building. We were made aware on being food smart and sustaining food for the future. On behalf of the management, principals, staff and students of the Delta Study, we wish to express our sincere thanks to manager Mr. Radhakrishnan and the team of the Brunton Boatyard. Our sincere thanks also goes to Dr. Priya Rao for making us aware about how to handle the waste and making it useful. We also thank Mr. Menon for demonstrating the use of the bio bin. Next, I would like to thank the staff of Mother Bhumi for joining the Brunton Boatyard and having organized such an awareness program. Let's all think, eat and say thank you.